होप माई स्क्रीन इज विजिबल टू ऑल ऑफ यू।
यस मैम।
ओके थैंक यू। सो दिस इज व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न। आर्स इज अ FIBSC बॉटनी क्लास एंड व्हाट टॉपिक आई एम गोइंग टू टेक इज अ पेपर वन यूनिट टू फंजाई। दिस यू ऑल मस्ट बी नोइंग फ्रॉम द लास्ट लेक्चर व्हाट वी हैड। So today what I am going to do is I am going to discuss whole of the syllabus, what all topics are covered in our unit 2, that is fungi. And is by chance any one of you have got the SAIT publication ka book what we refer for our botany syllabus? Has any one of you looked out for it or has seen the syllabus? I guess no, since we are not even aware of which publications to follow. So what this time we are going to do is we are going to put up the notices and the notes and PPTs. It will be shared through the Google Classroom. You all must have joined the Google Classroom by now. And by chance, if any one of you have not yet joined, so there was a code displayed in the WhatsApp group. So through that code, you can go to the Google Classroom app from your mobile, or you can go to the Google Classroom from your browser and join the classroom. So all the notes or these PPTs, what we are doing here will be shared through that. Whatever assignment or whatever we do in the class will be shared through the Google Classroom, the official portal for it. So before I start with any of the topic, first what I have the habit of is going through what all is there in the topic. क्या क्या हमको पढ़ना है? So that's why I'll be discussing what all is there in the syllabus, and with simultaneously we'll recall what all we may have studied till now related to the fungi. Okay. So our topic has been definitely divided into different subtopics. It has many different subtopics. And first of the topic, what we have in our syllabus is the general characters of phycomycetes. This is the first topic. Now, as you all know, the topic itself does not start with what are fungi, how they are classified and everything like this. It starts with the general characters of phycomycetes. So it is assumed that coming to the FIBSC, you all should be knowing that there is a classification, what all fungi are there, how they are classified on different bases, and what this particular class belongs to, phycomycetes. Okay, so if not known yet, we'll be doing a recall, or just we'll be summarizing what exactly different classes are, and then we'll be talking about the general characters of phycomycetes. This all will be covered in this particular topic. Now what is the methodology, how we are going to study the general characters? किसी भी हम डिवीजन या ग्रुप का जनरल कैरेक्टर्स स्टडी करते हैं तो देयर इज अ सेट पैरामीटर्स कि ये सारे टॉपिक्स कवर्ड होने चाहिए उसमें। ओके, सो दिस आल्सो हैज डिफरेंट टॉपिक्स, सब टॉपिक्स टू इट, बट ऑल शुड बी कवर्ड इन अ जनरल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स। सो फर्स्ट व्हाट वी टॉक अबाउट इज द अकरेंस। यू ऑल मस्ट बी वेरी फेमिलियर विद व्हाट इज अकरेंस। अकरेंस मीन्स इस कैटेगरी के, इस डिवीजन के जो भी फंजाए हैं वो आपको कहाँ कहाँ मिल सकते हैं। नाउ देर आर सो मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ फंजाई विच विल बी ग्रुप्ड अंडर दिस ग्रुप। सो वेर एवर द अकरेंस, वेर एवर द पॉसिबिलिटी, वॉट इज द परफेक्ट हैबिटेट फॉर देम, दैट विल बी डिस्कस्ड पर्टिकुलर टू द अकरेंस ऑफ द पर्टिकुलर फाइकोमाइसिटिस ग्रुप। देन वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट वॉट इज द हाइफल स्ट्रक्चर और वॉट इज द माइसेलियम of these particular group. So the division itself has a very specific characteristics. If these hyphal structure are present, then it should be grouped under this. Okay, so we'll be talking about hyphal structure. Now, if you are not aware of what is hypha, what is mycelium, then we'll be talking about these also in detail. What will be called as the mycelium, how the hyphae they grow, what is their structure, how the organization in the different divisions of the group takes place. So hyphal structure will be studied under this heading. What it is, its morphology, how it will look in cut section also. जो भी आपको प्रैक्टिकल्स में भी फंजाई स्टडी करने हैं, टू ऑफ द फंजाई, सो यू हैव टू टेक अंडर द माइक्रोस्कोप, लुक आउट फॉर हाउ द हाइफल स्ट्रक्चर्स आर देयर, सो माइक्रोस्कोपिकली ऑल्सो हाउ यू विल डिफाइन देम और हाउ यू विल स्टडी देम, दैट पर्टिकुलर थिंग विल बी कवर्ड अंडर द हाइफल स्ट्रक्चर. देन द थर्ड टॉपिक और वॉट द थर्ड थिंग वी स्टडी अबाउट इज द असेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन. Now, in higher organisms, we know asexual reproduction is almost negligible. But in the lower organisms, whether it is plants, whether it is, fungi, the asexual reproduction is also very rampant. Asexual reproduction bhi bahut, rapidly hota hai. This is seen in most of the fungi. So, we will be talking about what kind of asexual reproduction is taking place in relation to the phycomycetes. Now, when we talk about this particular topic, it is understood ki you all know what is asexual reproduction, what are different stages of it. So, in general characteristics, we will refresh also and we will learn also simultaneously what these terminologies will be dealt in. सबसे कॉमनेस्ट असेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन जो आपको प्लांट्स में पता होगा, जो हम घर पे भी यूज करते हैं, कटिंग्स करते हैं, यू टेक द स्टेम कटिंग एंड यू प्रोपोगेट. ये तो अगर आपके घर में गार्डन है तो यू ऑल मस्ट बी नोइंग अवेयर ऑफ कि ये कॉमनेस्ट, दिस काइंड ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन दे विल बी कॉल्ड एज द असेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन. सो फ्रेगमेंटेशन इज वन ऑफ द कॉमनेस्ट और कटिंग इज वन ऑफ द कॉमनेस्ट काइंड ऑफ असेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन. So, what all different kinds of asexual reproduction are in the phycomycetes, it will be dealt in this. Then there comes the sexual reproduction. What are different organs involved in it? What is the methodology? What all aid in the sexual reproduction of the phycomycetes group? That will be dealt with. We are not yet aware of, उनको हम imperfect fungi में include करते हैं. Others जिनका हमें sexual and asexual reproduction दोनों known है to mankind, they are termed as the true fungi. So this is one of the important aspects when we talk about the characters of a particular group. And lastly, what we'll be studying under the heading of characteristics are the life cycle pattern. What kind of life cycle pattern they follow? Haploid, diploid, haplodiploid, they are which kind of life cycle pattern they are adapting to, that will be dealt in. So in that, alternation of generation is also one of the most important terminology. How the change from the haploid to diploid takes place, or from how diploid to haploid takes place, alternate, what kind of this generation they are following, that is characterized or that is discussed under the heading alternation of generation. So whenever we have to write, now in questions it may be asked like give general characters of phycomycetes. So do page ka answer hai aur usko memorize karna is little tedious. So if you remember that I have to mention all these 5 points without missing anything, then you can write some points, whatever you know, what is occurrence, what are hyphal structure. If you remember, then you will be able to write your answers perfectly without missing out on any point. So that's why I have highlighted that if you are studying this particular topic, 5 points you should remember. So these are the 5 points which will be covered in our subsequent lectures, and we'll be discussing what all these individual points. So this was related to the first topic, or rather subtopic of our unit, that is unit 2, general characters. Now these are general characters, not specific to one particular fungus, but it is characteristics of all belonging to this group. I hope I'm making sense, whatever I'm telling you all. The second thing comes, now we have seen the general characters. So we see two type specimens coming from this particular group. One of them is Rhizopus, and the second one is Aspergillus. Ye dono bhi fungus is group ko belong karte hain, that is Phycomycetes. So now we'll be talking about individually all both these fungi related to some topics. Now, how the study of the fungi should be taking place? What are the characters? What are the points you should remember when you are defining or characterizing a fungus? So again, few points will be taken care of. First of all, you should know the systematic position of a particular organism, what you are studying. आप जो study कर रहे हो उसकी systematic position हमको पता होनी चाहिए, या फिर हमको पता करनी है. You study that fungus, what characteristic it has, and you put it into some group. So this is one of most important subtopics under the heading of the Rhizopus or Aspergillus, जो आपको exams में questions में आ सकता है, whether it is MCQ kind of a question paper or whether it is a subjective, जहाँ पे आपको describe करना होता है. So we'll be talking about the systematic position of both the fungus, what we are going to study. Then occurrence, where exactly these fungus will be found. आप लोगों ने घर पे भी देखा होगा, whenever you leave anything, something, कुछ खाने का material, specifically अगर आपने bread छोड़ दिया है या रोटी रह गई है, दो दिन बाद अगर आप उसमें देखोगे तो you will find some kind of growth over there. So that is what, that is nothing but the fungus, है ना? Fungus ke diseases bhi aapko pata hi honge, fungal infections hote hain, what type ke. So where exactly these kind of fungus, Rhizopus and Aspergillus, both they occur, hame kaha mil sakte hain in our habitat. Fungus ke bahut sari plant diseases bhi hote hain, majority of the plant diseases jo hoti hain wo fungus ki wajah se hoti hain. So we will be talking about the occurrence, where exactly these two will be occurring. Then comes the thallus structure. अगर ये grow हो रहे हैं यहाँ पर तो कैसे दिखेंगे, उनका morphology कैसे होगा, उनका mycelium का structure कैसे होगा. Fruiting body है तो what kind of fruiting body they will be producing. So we'll be talking about the thallus structure. Now you all should know what is a thallus, what is organism, what is plant. इसके बारे में हमको detailed में study करना है, what is the thallus structure. Then we'll talk about the nutrition, how it takes up its nutrition. Now you all should be aware of कि fungus जो हैं वो अपना खाना खुद नहीं बनाते. They are not autotrophic, they are heterotrophic. This is the one most particular, or rather a definition of the fungus. In this it comes that they are heterotrophic. Now heterotroph में भी आप लोग ने पढ़ा होगा already, there are different modes of nutrition. So what kind of nutrition it takes up, that will be studying in the topic nutrition. Then again, definitely we have to know how it reproduces, reproductive cycle and the life cycle pattern. Now you will see that ye sare jo topics hai, now we general characters mein bhi hum occurrence bolte hain, hyphal structure study करते हैं, reproduction study करते हैं, और sexual life cycle pattern study करते हैं. तो ये topics आपके general characters के same होते हैं. What you should know additional is the systematic position. Whenever it is given a particular fungus to describe, a systematic position should be mentioned over there. So ये these all will be repetition of your general characters, उसमें इसका particular characters लिखने हैं related to these 5 points plus systematic position of that particular fungus. We will be studying Rhizopus and Aspergillus. Now, this is related to the second topic, what we are going to cover. Then definitely comes the point, अगर हम इतना सब पढ़ रहे हैं तो उसका इम्पोर्टेंस क्या है, है ना? जैसे आप लोग पूछते हैं, मैडम इतना आप तो पढ़ा है, उसमें से वीआईपी क्या है, मतलब इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस कौन से हैं जो आने वाले हैं. सो अगर ये फंगस हम पढ़ रहे हैं तो डेफिनेटली व्हाट इज इट्स इकोनॉमिक वैल्यू, हमको पढ़ने के बाद फायदा क्या होने वाला है. सो इकोनॉमिक इम्पोर्टेंस वी हैव टू स्टडी. नाउ इकोनॉमिक इम्पोर्टेंस में जरूरी नहीं है कि वो देखकर कुछ हमें पैसे मिलते होंगे, फायदा होता होगा, ऐसा ही होता है. इकोनॉमिक इम्पोर्टेंस वी स्टडी ऑन टू बेसिस. व्हाट इज बेनिफिशियल एक्टिविटीज ऑफ दोज पर्टिकुलर ऑर्गेनिजम्स जो हमें बेनिफिट करते हैं, कुछ नॉट जस्ट इनकम बट व्हाट काइंड ऑफ मटेरियल वी कैन गेट, व्हाट काइंड ऑफ एक्टिविटी व्हाट दे डू व्हिच इज बेनिफिशियल फॉर अस, दैट वी स्टडी. एंड देन वी ऑल्सो स्टडी हार्मफुल एक्टिविटी. अगर ये हमें हार्म करने वाला है सो हाउ वी शुड प्रोटेक्ट. अगर ये हमारे प्लांट्स को हार्म कर रहा है, हमारा नुकसान हो रहा है, तो हाउ वी शुड प्रोटेक्ट अवर प्लांट्स. इफ इट इज कॉजिंग सम डिजीज, हाउ वी शुड प्रोटेक्ट आवर सेल्फ फ्रॉम दोज डिजीज. दैट इज ऑल्सो द इकोनॉमिक इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ इट. सो विल बी बेनिफिशियल एक्टिविटीज में विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट व्हाट डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ materials we can get, what different kind of activities what we get from it. So in that we can say edible hai mushroom, then yeast hai for the fermentation, then antibiotic. Now antibiotics are substances which kill bacteria, all of us know. So most of the antibiotics jo abhi aaj available hai, many of them they come from the fungus. Why so? Because fungal have the best competitor bacteria and bacteria have the best competitor fungus. So what has happened in environment, agar aapko compete karna hai to aapko kuch strong points hone chahiye. So that's why these fungus they secrete some substances jiski wajah se bacteria grow nahi ho pate, some kind of bacteria. And what we do, we extract those substances and they are termed as the antibiotics. So major chunk of the antibiotics in the pharmaceutical, it comes from the fungus. Then we have harmful activities also. You will be aware of ki plants mein bahut kabhi kabhi to white color ka powder hone lagta hai, ya rot hone lagte hain, brittle hoke tootne lagte hain, rust jaisa kuch milta hai. Ye sare jo plant diseases hain, they are caused by the fungus aur wo crops ko bahut nuksan pahunchate hain. एट अ टाइम मतलब एकर ऑफ एकर लैंड जो है वो फिनिश हो सकती है इफ यू आर नॉट ट्रीटेड. अगर वो ट्रीट नहीं किया गया तो पूरी की पूरी फसल वैनिश हो सकती है. बहुत यू नो डेडलीस, बहुत रैपिडली स्प्रेड होते हैं, उनके स्पोर्स बहुत रैपिडली स्प्रेड होते हैं. एंड इफ यू हैव गॉट गुड लॉट ऑफ क्रॉप देन इट मे यू नो हार्म अ लॉट. सो जो फंगल डिजीजेज होते हैं प्लांट्स के, नाउ एनिमल्स के भी देर आर लॉट मेनी फंगल डिजीजेज. सो वी विल नॉट बी डिस्कसिंग ऑल ऑफ देम, बट देर आर हार्मफुल एक्टिविटीज जिनसे हमें प्रिवेंशन की बहुत जरूरत होती है. सो दीज आर द इकोनॉमिक इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ द फंगस व्हाट विल बी डीलिंग विद रिलेटेड टू द टू टॉपिक्स. देन वी हैव द फोर्थ इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक एंड दैट इज द मोड्स ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन. How fungus takes nutrition, how we take nutrition from fungus, aisa nahi hai. Modes of nutrition is how fungus takes nutrition of its own. So that is also been dealt with in detail. So in short, you should know that only two kinds of modes of nutrition which are found in fungus. There is no autotrophic nutrition. They do not produce their own food. So they are dependent on something else. Now, when they are dependent on something else, either they could be parasites, parasitism, whereby here you can see there is a tree trunk and what the structure what you are seeing, these are the fungus, basidiocarps of the fungus. And internally, the hyphae will be going inside the stem of the plant and they will be penetrating to your vascular bundles. Vascular bundles, you all know, they carry the food material and the raw material. So slowly, slowly they start taking up, they flourish, and when the vascular bundles they start constricting because of them, the plant will die off, a slow death. So that's why these kind of fungus, they could be parasites on the plants. This is one of the kind of the mode of nutrition. It could be parasites. And the second is saprophytism. In saprophytism, they grow on the dead materials. You all must be aware of. So here we can see on soil, utilizing the materials on the soil, whatever has been there, organic materials, they take up and they grow. So they are saprophytism. These are the two different kind of nutrition what we are going to study in our syllabi. Now, since these are the topics which are to be studied in our syllabus, you all should be aware of some basic background of it. So, आप लोगों को थोड़ा सा इसका background knowledge होना चाहिए कि what something what you have already studied in your previous standards, because we know primary section से लेके to your junior college this topic is there. In the syllabi, and you all must have read it for your exams also. अभी MHCET exam चल रहे हैं, NEET exams चल रहे हैं, अभी हुए नहीं हैं, तो काफी लोगों ने preparations की होंगी already. So let us now go to a quiz, a Kahoot quiz मैंने prepare की है for you all. In this, I'll be just putting up the link the way I have done in our previous lecture. एक link है, आपको वो click करनी है. If you have the app, then you can go to your app. If you do not have the app, just click on the link. A browser will open and you will be able to see your question. You can play that. Now, in this question, one thing has been different from the previous one, that there is a timer. So every question will have 20 seconds some time, 20-30 seconds ka time rahega. You will see the bar which is going, decrease hote jayegi, time jaise jaise kam hoga. And within those much of time, you have to answer what is the correct answer. And if you skip on anyone, then the question is gone. It will be skipped. It will be marked. And then you will move on to the further one. During any taking up the quiz, try that you have a good network now, which is not in your hand. And you are able to finish this. There will be some 8-10 questions around that. And that we all can attempt. I didn't got a single raising hands in between. I don't know whether you all were able to hear or no. Okay, very good. All have been very attentive, I can see, and I hope you all enjoy doing it. What I'm going to do is right now is a the link. So how many students we all are here? More than, okay. We have 65. Okay, so in one link, I guess 50 of you would be able to join. So that's why I'll be sending two links. Okay, so first link I'm sending, all of you try to join it. Then I'll send after 5 minutes second link, and those who are not able to join through this link, they will be able to join the next link. थोड़े free version में थोड़े से restraints होते हैं. बट वी ऑल आर स्मार्ट इनफ, इवन यू ऑल आर स्मार्ट इनफ, तो हम लोग उसको क्या करते हैं, कोप अप कर लेंगे, है ना. सो होप द लिंक इज विजिबल टू ऑल ऑफ यू. जस्ट ट्राई दिस आउट एंड आई एम प्रीटी श्योर दैट यू ऑल आर गोइंग टू एंजॉय इट. एंड मोस्ट ऑफ द क्वेश्चन जो इजी क्वेश्चन हैं वो आपको आने वाले हैं. सो आई विल ऑल्सो बी वेरी हैप्पी विद दिस. I guess all have finished doing their quiz.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, and how do you all found it? How was the quiz? It was only the basic what you all should be knowing. Cute. Okay, yes, I know it's extremely easy. So I hope that all of you have got good score. Did you all able to see your scores? What questions you did right? What questions you did wrong? It was fun, good. Okay, sound was very nice. Good. Okay, so I hope I have a good response for it. So this is what I'm looking forward to it. So as and when we are able to finish any topic or subtopic, then we'll be able to recall it through this way. And this is known research kind of a thing. Ki aap jo visually karte ho ya aap jo repeat karte ho, वो आपके माइंड में ज्यादा जाता है. सिंस यू ऑल हैव बीन यू नो थ्रू योर बोर्ड एग्जाम्स 12th के, सो यू ऑल मस्ट बी अवेयर ऑफ कि कितना डिफिकल्ट होता है मेमोराइज करना, याद करना. दीज आर द टूल्स विच विल हेल्प अस इन रिमेम्बरिंग सो मेनी ऑफ द थिंग्स. एंड वी आर स्टिल नॉट श्योर वेदर विल बी हैविंग एन एमसीक्यू बेस्ड क्वेश्चन पेपर दिस टाइम और अ सब्जेक्टिव. सो इट इज अ गुड वे कि हम लोग रिवाइज भी कर सकते हैं इससे, यू नो कौन से टाइप के क्वेश्चन पूछे जा सकते हैं. So that also will be able to see that. So you will have a question bank also ready with you by the time we finish off our semester. Did you all got your answers, correct answers? And your scores, all of you? So I'll not be sharing that here. You all already know that how well you have performed. So, I mean, I get to know everyone. स्कोर यू ऑल्सो गेट टू नो द सेम स्कोर. आपने कौन सा क्वेश्चन राइट किया है, आपको पॉइंट्स कैसे मिले हैं. नाउ दिस पॉइंट्स आर कैलकुलेट, यू विल सी दैट देयर आर सर्टेन पॉइंट्स, थाउजेंड्स के रेंज में, 800-700 के रेंज में कुछ पॉइंट्स मिलते हैं. दैट इज कैलकुलेटेड एज पर द टाइम यू टेक टू आंसर एंड वॉट करेक्ट आंसर यू डू. सो उसके हिसाब से ग्रेडिंग हो जाती है. अदरवाइज सबने 10 के 10 करेक्ट किए हैं तो सबको 10 out of 10 ही मिलने वाले हैं. So that's why it's a kind of a game, जैसे हम बोलते हैं rapid fire. So if you all have enjoyed, so we'll definitely be putting up such kind of quiz again. And it's nice to see you all interacting and enjoying such kind of a session. What I wanted to know is, did any one of you had difficulty in opening the link? Open नहीं हो रहा है या any of that kind of problem? और एनीवन किसी के मोबाइल में सिर्फ ऐप में ओपन हुआ है ऐसा कुछ? नो. ओके, थैंक यू. इफ यू ऑल हैव एंजॉयड द क्विज देन डेफिनेटली विल बी हैविंग. ओके, सो दिस इज द काइंड ऑफ अ थिंग विच वी कैन डू. लास्ट टाइम हम लोगों ने जो गूगल फॉर्म लिया था उसमें यू नो ईमेल एड्रेस डालना पड़ता है. तो किसी किसी को प्रॉब्लम्स हो रहे थे, दे डिडंट न्यू देयर ईमेल एड्रेस एंड अनलेस अंटिल यू फिनिश ऑफ ऑल, सो यू नो थोड़ा सा डिफिकल्ट हो जाती है. So I hope this is a good platform and we'll definitely keep learning more of the things. Now the question answer session. Last time main hi bole ja rahi thi. Is time aisa nahi hona chahiye. You all should also get to speak. So any one of you have any queries related to our topic or any general queries jo aapko puchni hai, malum karni hai, then you can definitely unmute yourself and you can definitely say. Many have already said no, they don't have any problem. Okay. So now this was the revision kind of a thing. From the next lecture, we'll be starting with our topic, that is the fungi. And the first thing what we are going to take, you all should be remembering, that we'll be talking about the general characters. Okay. So I say my lecture is over. Till then, take care all of you. Thank you all of you.
Thank you, ma'am.
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 Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, all of you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Take care of yourself. Be safe at your place.